Restrooms are located just outside the gym entrance.
Our Booster Club is selling beverages, snacks, and hot food, so please help support the club. Please no food or drinks in the gym. Enjoy your purchases in the cafeteria area, and be sure to clean up all the trash.
Please adhere to the rules of the venue and respect event staff instructions to secure a safe environment. Please be aware that the use of any prohibited substances, such as drugs, tobacco products, or alcohol, is not allowed anywhere on school grounds.
Most importantly, Valley Regional High School is a CIAC Class Act school. We uphold the standards of sportsmanship, respect, and character at our athletic events. Our student athletes and spectators will demonstrate these standards at all times, as we recognize our responsibility to create a safe, positive atmosphere for athletics. Specifically, intense criticism of officials, personal insults by using students' names or numbers, or the use of profanity are grounds for removal from the event. Tonight's game is being officiated by Don, Sarah, and Taylor Rosillo. Please help us thank these officials for all they do. And now for the starting lineups. For our guests, the Blue Devils, head coach Mike Green.
Good evening and welcome to Valley TV's production of tonight's boys basketball match between the Coginchaug Blue Devils and your Valley Warriors.
We got a good matchup here between the Valley Warriors and the Blue Devils tonight, as the Warriors just came off of a tough loss, but a very, very well-played game against the Huskies. As I personally commentated that game, and that was a very, very well-fought game between both the two teams, and we were talking about how the Warriors really learned a lot from that game.
Today we are joined by our middle school students, We got six people on camera with us today. As Valley will start it with the ball. Rex in the corner, Grabowski. Top to Dolinsky. Now it's Connor Quinn, team's leading scorer.
You're going to see the Blue Devils here tonight really focusing on Connor Quinn and Noah Dolinsky, because they know that that is their main threat. As I'm not wrong, that was Max Smith going up for two there. But as I was saying, you're going to see the Warriors really be looking for those two, but you're also going to see the Blue Devils playing very good defense against the two of them, as they know that is the main point of this Warriors team. But as we saw last game against the Huskies, the Warriors are able to do a lot more than they were thought to do. They were playing very well in the paint, and they're playing just an overall very good game, even though they had a tough loss against the Huskies.
That's right, Adam. This Valley offense starts with those two big names, as Quinn's got it now. Dolinsky in the corner, and he's got it. Money from the corner from Noah Dolinsky, right on cue. Deep pass in the corner, Nickel intercepts it. He'll wait for his point guard mate, Connor Quinn. He'll drive, kick out. Dolinsky, no shot this time. Swing to Nickel. Fakes, drives. Nickel inside, Max Nickel. Little bit extra on that too.
We're gonna see the Warriors here really working the ball around that three-point arc here. As in the previous game, they were getting pressure down on their own end of the court. And they're really taking advantage of this lacking pressure as Connor Quinn gets fouled and still, as he will be going to, no he will not. Max Nickel will be passing the ball in here for the Warriors.
Call on the floor, Driscoll's got it in the corner. Quinn again. Dolinsky puts it up again. And that was just long. Coginchaug the other way. They like to get out and run. They'll hit you in the fast break. And a reach coming from Rex Grabowski. Coginchaug loves to shoot the threes. They go on a bunch of big runs throughout the point of their game, and they love to get out and run. As Driscoll's gonna tip that one out of bounds.
We saw that this Warriors defense last game against the Huskies could really work with anything that they were thrown at. That was thrown at them, sorry. They were really putting the heavy pressure on some of those three-point shots, and they're also working extremely well in the paint with a bunch of rebounds from a bunch of different players, especially junior Rex Grabowski, who had 9 rebounds on the game, along with 5 blocks, and a lot of that came in the paint on those defense plays, as there's a breakaway, as Dolinsky goes up for 3, and just barely misses that one. But as I was saying, we're really going to see this Warriors defense working with what they learned last game from those Huskies, as they know that the Huskies are a very strong opponent. As Jake Rainey goes up for 3, and it just slips out.
Quinn the other way. Lots of threes early from Coginchaug, none falling. Driscoll's on the inside, and he's gonna go up strong and finish. 9-0 early. Interesting press from Valley. A trap in the corner, nowhere to go until the inside. And an easy layup, rims out, and it's out off of Coginchaug. Valley ball.
There's that strong defense there from the Warriors, that aggressive defense, really not letting shots out and not letting any rebounds go back to the offensive team there. That is a travel there on the Warriors.
Foul on the floor. Logan Bender got fouled. He'll take it out of bounds.
Fouled there by Rex Grabowski.
Rebound long, Jack Driscoll. Nichols got it, running the floor. Quinn, back to Nichol. Swing into the corner is Dolinsky. Off the screen, Connor Quinn. Off Dolinsky, long rebound. He'll put it up, and he's got it. Noah Dolinsky's second three of the game early.
That's that power there of the Warriors' offense. The two of Noah Dolinsky and Connor Quinn can really shoot the ball. And if Connor can't get that shot, he's always looking for Noah Dolinsky. But it also shows because they're very strong with rebounding the ball, as we've seen both defensively and offensively. And that really helps him in the paint with guys like Jack Driscoll on the court and Rex Grabowski.
We've seen a hot start for this Valley offense. 12-0. As Alec Rodriguez will take it out from underneath the basket. He'll get it back. Dish to the corner for Laney. Kick out, another Coginchaug three. That one's also too long. Offensive rebound goes up. Driscoll, good contest. It's put back up. Shot will count. And going to the line is big man Aiden Oswald. He's 6'2".
We also have to give a lot of credit here to this Coginchaug team. They are 6-2 overall and 5-1 in the short run, so they're definitely a strong opponent. As the Warriors, I'm sure, know that coming into this game. We've seen them, they're playing a very aggressive game. They're getting extremely close on a lot of these shots here, as you're going to be seeing them get the first points on the board here. And they're going to be really looking to continue their very well streak at the beginning of the season here and really try to capitalize on this Warriors low point. But as you're talking about last game, the Warriors had an extremely hard stretch of some of the best teams they're going to play all season. And there's a steal there from Coginchaug as that they're really going to be looking to try to play with that momentum that the Warriors really have lost. As Olivia Cunningham here is going to check in for Rex Grabowski.
As she checks in, what an amazing story from Olivia. Of course, no girls basketball team this year. Free throw from Matthew Yale. Rims out. Already a bonus for Coginchaug, which is a bonus for Coginchaug. They'll give him free throws on every Valley foul. As Quinn will take it up. Quinn dancing at the top of the arc. Nice move. Misses the shot as Henry Bugay the third brings it down. Swing it to the corner for Brooke Laney. No good. Henry on the inside. They get fouled going up. Bonus doesn't matter. He'll get free throws anyways on the shot.
Coginchaug here is definitely going to be using their aggressive approach to this game as Henry Guy the third goes up and makes the free throw. But as I was saying, Coginchaug is going to be looking to really use that aggressive approach. They saw it work really well last week against the Warriors with the Huskies. They were a very aggressive team, and the Warriors are going to be looking to play just as aggressive. As, yeah, there is a full court press here, which is what they saw last week, so they almost got used to it from those Huskies. They were able to work around as Dolinsky passes to Quinn. Still looking for that perfect shot. Troy in the paint. That is up and good. That's what I was saying there before. We've been seeing a lot of that three-point attack at the start of this game here. But the Warriors really have a lot more than just that three-point attack. They're really good in the paint, along with those three-point shots, as that shot is just barely missed there, maybe tipped by the Warriors defender. But another quick attack, and Troy just barely misses that as he's heavily contested by the Coginchaug defender.
Rainey's got it now. Yale on the outside. Loose ball picked up by Max Nickel. It come down the other way is Connor Quinn. No points for him yet, but here comes Dolinsky. Cunningham on the outside. Dolinsky's got the three. He's got it! Noah Dolinsky, his third already. And it forces a Coginchaug timeout. Noah Dolinsky has three early threes. Valley leads 17-4.
You've seen a hot start here from the Warriors. They're really going to be looking in this timeout here to continue playing it and continuing to work with that hot start. And the Coginchaug defenders here, who are playing a pretty good game, and they're getting a lot of opportunities here, just barely missing by that the heavily contested Warriors defense here. They're going to be really looking to capitalize on those shots and get this game closer as it really should be. Coming to the timeout here, it's going to be a Coginchaug ball, as the Warriors are probably going to be looking to continue that full court press, as Coginchaug is doing here as well.
Little jersey situation in the corner. One thing that this Coginchaug team does have up on Valley is that height. They got some height on the inside. Valley a little on the smaller side, but they got the grit. As in the corner, now inside to some of that height. That one's gonna go long. And we have a foul on Coginchaug. And as we just saw, number 33 signal, here comes a full court press. Bugai making sure his guys are in the right spot. 34 comes back, Eden Oswald.
You've seen the Warriors working with that full court press here by just playing the ball quick. They're making it so that the Coginchaug defenders can't possibly get back and fight against that full court press.
Timeout from Coach Woods. Nickel couldn't find anywhere to get the ball. B Valley's first. Little bit of a slower start than head coach Mike Brady was looking for Coginchaug. 17-4. That just shows you how good this Valley team can be. Defense is working, only allowed four. Again, shout out to our JW helpers today as we try to get some people to join us for the next years. They're all working the cameras for us. We got some directors. Just a quick shout out to them. Thank you for being here. Nickel will try to check it in again. Dolinsky's got it. He jumps and passes all in one. Dolinsky's got it on the outside. Connor Quinn. Nickel, Dolinsky, and Quinn have played pretty much the entire game. Quinn on the outside. Nice move, rebound long, Tommy Troy's got it. Goes up hard and draws the foul. Tommy Troy will have free throws.
where he misses the first. The second one is up and good. That'll give the Warriors an 18-4 lead here in the game with 56 seconds left in the first quarter.
Paul Giantonio checks in for Olivia Cunningham. Valley giving a 3-2 zone look. Inside. No good. Nickel has it punched out by his own teammate. Logan Bender will inbound. He's got Rodriguez on the outside. Now back in the corner. Bender, maybe a good pass, gets a shot, but Bender's going to drive. No good. Nickel. Nickel's got Quinn. Quinn looking for somewhere to go. He's got Paul. Paul's jumper is long. Rebound Rodriguez.
One notable thing here for this Coginchaug team is they have, I believe, 3 of the 5 players on the court are juniors, which means they will be returning next year. And teams really like to use that as their advantage. As Dolinsky goes up and just barely misses that one as time expires here. We saw a very, very strong half there from the Warriors, as they're really going to be looking to keep that up in this second. Did I say half? Sorry about that. In the second quarter here. And Coginchaug's really going to be working around that 3-point shot, as they've seen has worked extremely well for these Warriors here.
Quick start for these Warriors. They lead by 14 heading to the second quarter. 18-4.
Coginchaug's really going to be using this end of the quarter there to their advantage. It's a free timeout, essentially, for their coach. And they're really going to be looking to just talk things over. This Warriors team came out, obviously, a lot stronger than the record says, as they had a very, very tough game last week. And they really are playing off of that momentum that they had. Even though they lost, they still played a phenomenal game. And they know that this Coginchaug team is a very, very strong team. They're also a very aggressive team, which they are used to playing, as they also play that themselves. It is going to be a Coginchaug ball here to start.
Rodriguez rolls on the top of the head of Bender. Now a trap from Valley. Rodriguez is going to drive and just get stuffed. That tough Valley defense. Floater from Bender's long. Rebound is also long. Jumper. That one falls. Matthew Yale with the 2.
Like you so kindly pointed out there, James, this Warriors defense is very aggressive, like I was saying. Like, they came out strong. And they were moving quick, and they were really trying to make sure that Coginchaug was not able to get a shot. As Coginchaug is doing the same back to the Warriors, as that is a foul there. Troy here from the line again. Up. Just barely misses that one.
Second foul for Oswald. Takes him out for Preston Manone. Troy sinks the second free throw. Cunningham will check in for Giantonio. Rodriguez, rather tall point guard, bringing it up. Looking for someone to go. That one's tipped by Tommy Troy. He leads the team in steals. That one's good. Cunningham on the inbound. Troy in the middle. That one's tipped, and here comes Coginchaug. And here's another jumper. That one's short. Rebound going up hard, and they're going to call the jump ball. That's Valley's.
Like we've seen, as you were pointing out in the first half, the height is really working for these, for Coginchaug tonight. They're collecting these offensive rebounds, and that's really helping them get a lot of opportunities here tonight. As Max Nichols is going to be checking the ball in here. Tommy Troy with the save there from the steal. The ball goes out on Coginchaug.
Coginchaug looking for some momentum as Quinn's got it. When this team gets on a run, they're dangerous. They like that aggressive defense. On the outside is Cunningham, now to Quinn. Nichols floaters off. Rodriguez in the corner, guarded by Dolinsky. That one's tipped by Troy. You can see why he leads his team in steals. Aggressive player. Almost gets his hand on another one inside. And a good block from Dolinsky, rebound Cunningham. That one gets the crowd loving it. Dolinsky, screen from Nickel. Dolinsky's gonna drive. Going hard and draw the foul. Dolinsky's not afraid to go in with the trees.
That there is a product of an aggressive game from both defenses. You're gonna see a lot of fouls and a lot of free throws. And that is what some teams really look to use to their advantage, as it's really worked for both teams here. As Dolinsky is here from the free throw line. First one is good. The second one is good. Dolinsky is having himself a night here tonight. As we've seen, a lot of pressure on Connor Quinn, so they're just using the other three-point shooter. That ball is very, very unlucky miss there from Coginchaug. But we're still seeing that full court press here from them, trying to slow down this Warriors offense, which they've done a very good job of. Quinn's moving up the court quick. We got Dylan Brown in the corner. He's up and good.
Bench loves the big man three. Dylan Brown sinks it. Coming back quick, he's Coginchaug, and there's the foul. Everybody in Warrior Nation on their feet for Dylan Brown. Foul on Tavis Felacion. Bender looking. Rodriguez is going to take it. And it's knocked away by Quinn, fighting for the ball. Troy's got it, it's rolling in the corner too fast.
That's hustle right there.
That right there is almost another steal from Tommy Troy, as you were saying before. He's leading this team in steals per game.
Aggressive, and he hustles. He was roaring down that court looking for the ball. As we got a meeting for the refs, maybe to discuss possession. Bugai will check in. Bender awaits the pass. Warrior Nation getting into it. Quinn is going to get aggressive. Bender's picking up the dribble. Deep pass. Got it in the corner. Looking inside. Good job by Valley to squeeze the court. Rodriguez just can't get anything going against this defense. Bender gets past one, and there's another. This 3-2 zone is working. And a shot clock violation. How about that? This Valley defense is playing the best basketball I've seen all season. outstanding defense, and Coginchaug's going to back up, only one up against Quinn. Quinn's going to drive. Foul will be on Valley. It'll be on Tommy. Tommy Troy. Tommy's first, Troy's first. Bender brings it up. Troy awaits him. And Valley's not giving him any room to breathe.
Valley's going to try
tipped
to keep
again.
Valley's going to try to keep this lead here as big as they possibly can because of they know how good this Coginchaug team is. They know that if they figure out a way to get around this defense here that they are going to start scoring and they're going to bring this game a lot closer. As that is going to be a Coginchaug ball there. I think the biggest, the most notable thing here for the Warriors is they really have only two big guys on the court. And this Coginchaug team is tall, as we were talking about before. Really, their two big guys being Tommy Troy and Dylan Brown here. And that's really the big difference. As there is a fast breakaway for the Warriors. As Tommy Troy driving to the basket and just barely misses that one with an unlucky bounce.
Rodriguez brings it back, running fast. Tavius meets him up, and it's going to go. Quinn's got it. He'll pass to Tavis. Tavis snags it right before it goes out of bounds. He'll drive, and he'll have an easy deuce. The freshman scores. Rodriguez, pressure from Quinn. Ball's on the floor, and they call the foul. Rodriguez inbound. Rainey's got it. Checked in for Bender. Valley trapping him. Nowhere to breathe, and he's going to go up. And a foul on Dylan Brown. Luke Portanicki sinks his first. 26-11 Valley, 3:19 in the first half. Warrior Nation maybe rattles him a bit. Tommy Troy, strong rebound. Tavis back up the other way. He's got Dolinsky. Dolinsky's not afraid to pull it, he does. And he's got it! Noah Dolinsky again, his fourth of the game. Now momentum and Valley's side. And a hold from Tommy Troy. Nickel will check back in. Dylan Brown comes out. Noah Dolinsky shooting the rock well tonight. He's got four threes. Rodriguez has his first one. Connor Quinn now.
Connor Quinn pushes through the paint there as the Blue Devils here take over.
Rodriguez in the corner, Bugay. Got it on the inside, Luke Portanicki. Connor Quinn. Noah Dolinsky. Tommy Troy in the corner. Inside to Nickel. He's got that easy layup. Max Nickel. 31-15 Valley. Dolinsky on the fast break. Easy layup.
Coginchaug taking their time here, looking for that shot. That is going to be a foul on Connor Quinn here. The first one up here for Alec Rodrigo. Two Coginchaug players are going to check out here, along with the freshman from Valley, Tavis Falacione here. Second one goes up, and it's good. It's going to make this a 16-point lead here for the Warriors. There's a minute and 30 seconds left into the half. Coginchaug ball here as Logan Bender is taking the ball off the court here.
Bender in the corner, Rodriguez. Dolinsky's got it.
Warriors ball here. This is Olivia Cunningham. Still looking for that shot here for the Warriors. They were doing a lot of last game until that, really that second half. This is Grabowski to Quinn. To Cunningham. To Quinn. Driving to the basket, and that is a steal for the Blue Devils here. As Logan Bender into the paint. Logan Bender up for three. Just barely misses that one. As a very lucky rebound for Blue Devils there. There are 35 seconds left in the game here, or in the half, sorry.
Connor Quinn now. Drives, kicks to Cunningham. Cunningham looking for Dolinsky's got it. Dolinsky's gonna pull it again. No good this time. Rebound Bugai. Bender. Looking for Rodriguez, he's got him. Bender's got it back. Inside, good ball movement. And that is going to be our first half. 14-point Valley lead.
All right, good evening and welcome to Halftime, folks. This is Brad Pittman, former Coach Pittman to these guys. We got a couple Valley Warrior basketball alumni here with us, D'Angelo Jean-Pierre and Andrew Reimerson, last year's starting backcourt. Fellas, what do you think of the game so far?
We're up. We're breaking their press pretty easy, making shots, playing good defense in our tempo. I think we're playing pretty well. That's why we're up.
Nice. And I know you guys have been to a few games leading into this. We've had a couple that have gone the wrong way. Andrew, what do you see so far that's making the difference in this game for the Warriors?
It seems like they're playing way more aggressive. They're going for offensive rebounds, and especially they're pushing it. And when they're making shots, you know, they're getting hype and, you know, playing with good morale, and shots are falling. Times are good.
Excellent. Yeah, the energy is surely there for the boys tonight. So, guys, you've moved on to college. D'Angelo, you're at Central. Andrew, URI, how's college life treating you so far?
It's all right. It's a bigger high school at Central. I know URI is bigger, but Central, it's all right. It's a good small community college.
You guys getting athletic opportunities, even if you're not necessarily on the Central Blue Devils playing field, or the Rhode Island, I'm forgetting their names, Rams, the Rams courts. But any intramurals going on, Andrew?
Yeah, when we come back from break, me and John Alme and I from Old Line, we're running 5-on-5 intramurals with the frat squad, so we hope to, you know.
Love it, love it. I played a ton of intramurals in college. It's a great way to stay active and continue to love the game. Well, fellas, enjoy the second half. Thanks for joining us and updating us on things. And thanks for tuning in for Valley TV. Enjoy the rest of the game, folks.
We got a Warriors 14-point lead here coming out of the half, and this is going to be a Coginchaug ball to start off the half here. Coginchaug definitely had some talks about how trying to figure out how to stop this Warriors offense and really just put their shots on target. Not on target, just really hope that they get those lucky bounces in the basket here that they've really just been getting extremely unlucky on. It's going to be a Coginchaug ball here. Right in the paint, just barely missed. As Connor Quinn's marching up the court here. Jack Driscoll. Max Nickel.
Grabowski's got it back to Nickel. Smacked out of bounds by Rodriguez. It'll say Valley ball. They come out into the second half, leading by 14. Noah Dolinsky's been on target today. This one to Grabowski. Here's Quinn. He's got Nickel, and Nickel's got a three.
Warriors extending that three-point attack to now Max Nickel as well. As Coginchaug's going to be looking to respond here. As that is Jake Rainey. And Rodriguez up for three and good.
Quinn the other way. He's got Dolinsky, leading scorer of the game. Grabowski's in the corner. He's got Driscoll. Back to Grabowski. Nice pass. And met up by Portanicki. Bugai the other way. Drives, corner, bender, no shot. And a great job by the Valley interior defense.
We got very different offenses here tonight. Coginchaug's playing the paint extremely well, and Warriors really taking those three-point shots and really making the most of them here. As you can see, Dolinsky here, one of those shooters. Now to Quinn, another one of those shooters here. There's, I believe, an illegal block by an offensive foul here by Jack Driscoll.
The guy checks it in. Jake Rainey's got it. He's got Bender inside Dubai and intercepted. Connor Quinn takes his turnover right back. Looking inside Driscoll. Ball knocked out by Rainey. Ball's on the floor, fighting for it. Driscoll's got it. Jump ball. It'll stay Valley ball. Great hustle from Valley to keep possession. Dolinsky, Driscoll now. Rex Grabowski's got it. Dolinsky's gonna charge. Fighting for the loose ball. It's Grabowski. It's still Grabowski. And it's out on Grabowski.
Be a Coginchaug ball here. Still working that paint, as I was saying before, as that is Ugai, the third up for two there. He's been really the top point of this attack.
Ooh, a little no-look pass that leads to the Jack Driscoll shot. He's fouled. He'll head to the line. Driscoll has free throws. Valley leads by 12, 5:23 in the third. That one's gonna fall a little short. That one will rim out as well. Dubai grabs a rebound. Rodriguez the other way.
It's a steal there from Connor Quinn. He's been having also a very good game here. Giving the ball to Noah Dolinsky for the three-point shots. So that's Grabowski in the paint, up and good for two. Like I was saying before, Coginchaug is going to be looking to respond to that, as they're going to be really looking to respond to every basket. That's another steal there by Jack Driscoll that time. As they're playing, the Warriors are playing quick here. Grabowski to counter Quinn, looking for that shot, and he goes up for it and gets it. Great shot there by Connor Quinn. That's going to bring the Warriors' score to 41.
Cunningham will check in. Driscoll comes out. Three fouls from Driscoll. Take him out of the game. 4:33 in the third. Rodriguez to check in. Adam, you mentioned the paint play of this Coginchaug team. Maybe they need to get back to their heart, this three-point shot. Blocked by Rex on the inside. Bender. Bender's going to put up the three. It's going to rim out. Rodriguez now. Bender outside. Yale. Jumper. He's going to rim out inside. And a foul by Max Nickel.
Giantonian in for Cunningham here. As it's still a Coginchaug ball. They get that open shot there, which they just barely miss. A little short by Matthew Yale. A good tip there from Connor Quinn, and it's touched before it goes out by Coginchaug, which means it is going to be a Warriors ball here as Cunningham checks back into the game. Quinn up the court.
And a moving screen from Rex Grabowski. Tommy Troy will check in for Rex.
That is his third foul of the night here.
Bender to the inside. Dubai kicks it out to Yale. Yale's going to drive, and that one. I believe Max is pushed by Preston Manone. He is. He'll inbound. Connor Quinn trapped. Full court press now. Looking deep. Tommy Troy off the fingertips. Rodriguez. Lines up for the three, and he's got it. His three-point shot for Coginchaug could play a big factor.
That's really what happens there with that full-court press. It puts the other team, it really makes them have to think quick. They can get the ball through. They have a great chance here. As that is a foul there. But as I was saying, that full-court press really makes the teams work and really makes them think. And if they can't get that ball out, there are going to be some quick points from Coginchaug here, as they're the ones who are really doing it to the Warriors here. The Warriors are really just trying to hold on to their lead. That is back down to 14 here.
Tommy Troy, Noah Dolinsky. Connor Quinn's got it now, guarded by Bender. That one's going to be intercepted by Yale. He's got a head of steam as he runs up the floor and lays it in. Fast break points coming from Coginchaug. This is an offense. They'll score quick. Dolinsky's got it. Connor Quinn. He'll take his time. Not heavy pressure. Max Nichols got it. Tommy Troy's got it on the outside. He's got Connor Quinn, and Connor Quinn has got the three. You can't leave him open like that, folks. Connor Quinn again. Extends this Valley lead to 15. Bender now. Good pressure from Valley. Good shot from Dubai. That one's going to be smacked. Quinn got it back in timeout from Coach Woods. Valley leads 44-31, 1:50 to go in the third.
This is that break that Coginchaug was looking for here. They're slowly taking down this lead, and they're slowly coming back here. And the Warriors in this timeout really going to be looking to just stop that Coginchaug attack, as they know it is a very, very strong attack, and they are a very strong team here. As the Coginchaug coach over here is probably talking a lot about just keep it up. Keep up the aggression on the court and just continue to do what they are doing as it's working. With a minute 50 left in the third, like I was saying before, the Warriors are going to be looking to stop them. There's essentially a quarter of basketball left to play here, besides this last minute and 50, which, you know, a lot can happen in that short amount of time, as we're still seeing that full court press here, just not as intense. But the Warriors.
Nichols got it. Full court press coming. Cunningham now. Good pass, Troy. Cunningham. Cunningham looking for somewhere to go. Good spin. Nice move, it's just off. And Nichol on the inside, fights for the board and gets the putback. Max Nichol. Warrior Nation loving it. Yale on the outside, Rodriguez. Rodriguez is going to pull the three, and that one's going to rim out. There'll be a hold on Alec Rodriguez. Nickel will check in. Quinn's got it. That foul was on Eden Oswald. That's his third. Connor Quinn's got it at the top. Dances with Yale. Pass to the inside. Troy goes up strong and met by Oswald. Going back the other way is Yale. To the corner is Bender, guarded by Cunningham. To the inside, Dubai. He loves those little elbow shots. He's got another one. Cuts the lead to 13. Cunningham's got it. Great ball vision there. Nichol to Connor Quinn for three. He's got another! Connor Quinn! A heat check three.
Watch 33 in the middle.
Dubai, Rodriguez in the outside. No good, Dolinsky. 18 seconds left. Dolinsky's gonna run up the floor. He's trapped. Nichol to Quinn. 11 seconds. Nichol now. Five to shoot. Time winding down. And Coach Woods wants these last 4.6 seconds to score some more points. A 60-second timeout from Woods.
You can see here that Coach Woods is really, he's really passionate about what he's trying to tell his team here. It's either he wants to score in these last 4.6 seconds, or he doesn't, and he wants to really just end out this quarter here and just get to the last one.
These last 4.6 seconds. Woods will send out his shooters. He got Nickel Cunningham, Troy Dolinsky, and Quinn. Nickel will inbound. They've got their play. Dolinsky, three to shoot, two, steps back and is blocked by Dubai. And he's going to heave it at the end.
At the end of the third quarter, we got a 49-33 game. Really just a very good game we've seen here tonight as the Warriors are coming off that tough loss against the Huskies and really looking to change a lot of the pace that they've had in these last couple of games here against a team that is very solid, like these 6-2 Blue Devils here. Coginchaug ball here. They're going to really be looking to start this quarter with points on the board. As that pass is overthrown. And there's going to be a Warriors ball.
Nickel to inbound. Entering the fourth. Coginchaug's going to back up. Interesting strategy here. Quinn's got it. Dolinsky. I think Coginchaug wants to make sure they're set as Noah's going to go up. He'll be fouled and he'll get two free throws. Third on Bender. Dolinsky sinks the first. You can hear a pin drop in this court right now.
Second one just misses there. As Coginchaug is marching up the court. That pass is just a little wide. And there's going to be a Warriors ball here. We're back to that full court pressure here from Coginchaug. As Nickel inbounds the ball here. And now the Warriors ease up that pressure. Coginchaug eases up that pressure. Nickel to Grabowski, to Dolinsky, to Quinn, to Nickel. Into the paint and back out to Dolinsky. Dolinsky up for three, just barely misses that one. As is going to be rebounded here by the Blue Devils. A steal there by Max Nickel. And the Warriors are going to slow the ball down here as they're really just trying to finish off this game tonight. Quinn to Driscoll. Back to Quinn. That's going to be a foul on Coginchaug. Is that a lead? Might be a reaching foul here from Coginchaug. He's going to be Nickel again inbounding the ball.
That foul will be Manone's fourth. They'll take him out. In comes Portanicki. Pass inside Driscoll. He's going to go up strong. And a couple seconds into his tenure in the game, Portanicki picks up a foul.
Driscoll here from the line. First one is made. The second one is good. There's that really strong 2-point game, that really strong game in the paint here from Henry Bugai the third here. Connor Quinn marching into the paint to Tommy Troy. He's up and he is good. Strong performance there from Tommy Troy. As Coginchaug is looking to respond, and they're looking to respond fast. Like we were saying before, that paint game is really working for these Blue Devils here tonight. We're seeing that full court pressure again.
We're seeing good ball movement here. Connor Quinn's got it, both teams. Connor Quinn, step back. Got it! Connor Quinn! Excuse me, he is feeling himself. Connor Quinn again. Rodriguez trapped on the outside. Rex Grabowski's going to go up. It'll be a foul. Woods trying to keep his team calm.
We're seeing a lot of fouls here from the Warriors, as we're seeing this paint game is really what Coginchaug is striving to do, as the first free throw goes up and is good. But Coginchaug's really, they're not looking to take the 3-point shots. They're looking to march into the paint, just get up and get those easy shots, those easy points. As the second one here is good. And that's really what these fouls are coming from, because it's really hard to stop an attack like that, especially a good one like these Blue Devils have. As we're still seeing that full court pressure, but that is a steal from the guy, the third, up in the paint, as we've seen him do best here. That is an offensive foul on him. We got a Warriors player down on the court right now.
Max Nickel a little slow to get up after taking that charge. Dubai is not a small man. That must have hurt. Hopefully he's okay. Sorry, Bugai.
Nickel's still down on the court, so we will take a little break here as this whole room is worried about him. Nickel gets up and this whole room is relieved here to see that he is okay after that pretty aggressive charge. Nothing on the player there. That's just part of the sport, and that's what happens here.
Cunningham will check in for Max Nickel, who heads off to the locker room. Tommy Troy's got it. Driscoll.
You see a defensive rebound here from Coginchaug. That is going to be a foul here on the Warriors. Like I was saying before, that paint game really just causes fouls. It really just brings it up and makes it more apparent throughout the game and can really save a team as that first one goes up and is good. The second one is good here.
Dolinsky spins, and he dragged that pivot foot. Bugai will check in to Rodriguez. Corner shot from Yale is good. Coginchaug looking to get back to the three ball. Driscoll's got it. Now Dolinsky. Dolinsky for three. No good. Grabowski inside. No good again. Driscoll rips it out. Driscoll to the corner. Dolinsky. He got that one. Takes two in that possession, but Dolinsky makes it fall. A drive from Rodriguez sent back by Grabowski. Another block from Rex. Dylan Brown will check in for Driscoll. Inbound Yale, shot short, rebound Grabowski. Dolinsky coming up the floor. Connor Quinn, he'll take his time. He's got plenty of it. He's gonna drive. And a foul on the floor. Valley, I believe, now in the bonus. We'll give him free throws.
We've seen there with that rebound there from Grabowski. That's something that he's done very well this season. As last game, like we were saying, he had 9 rebounds. And Quinn's first one goes up and is good. Quinn's second is up and good.
Jesco comes back in for Cunningham. Good guy to Rodriguez. Good news in the gym. Max Nichol has rejoined the team on the bench. He's smiling. I hope he's all right.
We're going to see a foul here from the Warriors as Rodriguez is going up, and that somehow lipped out for his first of two. And his second is up and good.
Connor Quinn's got it. He's going to have Dolinsky. Dolinsky's got to hustle for it. He's got it in the corner, though. Connor Quinn now. He'll reset the offense. Poked out by Yale. Rodriguez with the interception. Rodriguez on the outside. He's going to have Barrett in the corner. No good. Knocked out of Cunningham's hand by Coginchaug. Cunningham's got it. Connor Quinn. And a foul. That foul will be on Alec Rodriguez. 3:18 to play in the fourth. Valley leads 62-43. Driscoll heads to the line. Off on the first.
Jack's second is up. Just barely misses. Coginchaug has been taking this fast break here. They got Baker Barrett in the corner there, sorry. Right to the paint where they're best. That goes up and that is good for two.
Cunningham, Quinn. Quinn's gonna take off. Quinn's got a little bit of room. Delinsky in the corner. Delinsky too strong. Rodriguez running the other way. Rodriguez lays it in. And Coginchaug still fighting. Cunningham. Just go fights for that one. Quinn's got it at the top. Quinn's gonna drive. Dylan Brown, no good. Pass goes right out of bounds. Tommy Troy checks in for Dylan Brown. It's Valley ball. 2:22 to play. Valley leads by 15. Delinsky's got it. Guarded by Barrett, poked out. Woods making sure they got this call right. Under two to play.
This is getting a little spicy here as Barrett went back court with Delinsky there and is being talked over with Coach Woods over there.
Knocked out of bounds by Quinn. Barrett to inbound. Bugai. Barrett again. Too strong. Tommy Troy the rebound. Coginchaug backs up. Connor Quinn brings it up the floor. Delinsky. Troy open for Driscoll on the inside. Tommy Troy is no good. Rodriguez inside, no good. Jack Driscoll. Warrior Nation loves it.
Coach Woods is really trying to get his team here to slow down and really just try to finish out this game here. Sorry, we are not sure if we're having issues here or not. If we are, we apologize. Our little screen over here went black, so we don't know. That's Cunningham up in the paint. Just a little short on that. It looks like there's a foul there on Coginchaug, and this is going to be Cunningham at the free throw line here. First one is up and good, and Warrior Nation loves that. I just saw last game when she scored. They went crazy. Second one is up and good. She drains it there. It's going to bring the lead to, it's going to be a 64-47 game here with a minute left in the fourth quarter. A valiant effort from both teams tonight as the Warriors were looking to end that long, hard streak that they had to go through here. As that is up and good for two. Coginchaug, Quinn's taking it really slow here. Coginchaug still putting that full court pressure on them here. As they got Dolinsky to Quinn. Quinn's taking it nice and slow. While being aware of that shot clock, that is a new thing this year. Kind of Quinn drives to the basket and just barely misses that with the hard defense from the Blue Devils. As a shot is up and just barely missed in the paint for Bugai. And an offensive rebound again. And there it is up for Bugai. Good for two in the paint. With 14 seconds left, Warriors are going to really be looking to take it slow and just end this game here. They got Driscoll up court. Dolinsky. Quinn. 3 seconds left. And that'll end the game here. Warriors win it 64-51. Really statement win here tonight for the Warriors. Coginchaug coming into this game with 6-2. Warriors were 1-5. Now Coginchaug being 6-3, and the Warriors are going to be 2-5. Really ending that tough streak that they had to go through. Thank you for joining us here tonight. As we said before, final score, 64 Valley, 51 Coginchaug. And we will see you next time.